The top-ranked South Dakota State football team puts its 16-game win streak on the line at one of the most unique venues the Jackrabbit team has ever played tomorrow afternoon, Target Field, the home of the Minnesota Twins, as SDSU takes on the Drake Bulldogs. Hi, friends. Tyler Merriam, welcome to Gameday Eve, presented by Sanford Health. Want to remind you, if you haven't done so already, subscribe to our Jackrabbit Sports Network podcast, hours of weekly content. Wherever you podcast, become a subscriber to the Jackrabbit Sports Network. We are here at Irv Heater Field on the northeast side of the SDSU campus. Rob Bishop and the Jackrabbit baseball team calls this place home. The Jackrabbit football team will play at a baseball park tomorrow. Target Field, the home of the American League Central Division leaders, the Minnesota Twins. It's been open since 2010. It's hosted two college football games previously. This will be the third. And we hope for the heart rate, it isn't quite as exciting as last weekend's was as far as going down to the wire. Number one SDSU, number three Montana State in a classic in front of 19,332 fans. That's the second largest crowd to ever witness a sporting event in either of the two Dakotas. And you, Jackrabbit Nation, made a terrific impact, forcing Montana State into nine false start penalties. How big was that? Well, on at least two occasions, it likely forced Montana State head coach Brent Vegan to try for field goals instead of touchdowns. Montana State entered the red zone five times and scored only 16 points in those five trips to the Jackrabbit 20-yard line and inside of it. SDSU scored 13 points on its two red zone trips, and that really the difference of the football game. Now, the Jacks did not play the cleanest of games. They were also penalized seven times for 75 yards. Mark Gronowski, when it counted, though, rose to the occasion, as he so often does. He threw for 184 yards and two touchdowns and also had a 20-yard touchdown run. But his second touchdown pass, it was preceded by the 40-yard bomb to Graham Goring. Goring makes the sliding catch, and one play later, it's Gronowski to Griffin Wilde. What an effort by the true freshman Sioux Falls Jefferson product. The 35-yard catch and score to give the Jackrabbits the win. Brian Williams had a number of big plays defensively, one of many on the interior of that line that played well. Dyshawn Gales gets forgotten about. What about the pass breakup on that final drive for Montana State? If he doesn't get there, that might have been a Bobcat touchdown. Cale Reeder comes up with an interception. It really was a cast of thousands for the Jackrabbits on defense. Biggest concern, though, from that game for head coach Jimmy Rogers was the special teams. Missed a PAT, had a punt blocked, gave up a big kick return. That's an area they will be focused on going into tomorrow. The opposition, the Drake Bulldogs, they are a non-scholarship FCS program based out of Des Moines, Iowa, of course, member of the Pioneer League. Jacks and Drake are no strangers to one another. In fact, they played in 2019 in Brookings. SDSU a 38-10 win. Jacks racked up 369 yards on the ground. This is a Bulldog team under fifth-year head coach Tom Stepsis, who is 0-2. They lost their opener at North Dakota. Were very competitive for a half, down just 14-0, but UND routed them 55-7. Then they played another national champion last week. They played Northwestern of Iowa, NAIA defending champions, and lost in overtime 27-24. In that game, 11 different receivers caught a pass for the Drake offense, but they were just very poor as far as avoiding penalties. Got flagged 14 times in the game for 153 yards. Hard to win when you commit that many penalties. But they are capable of putting together impressive scoring drives against Northwestern. Just as an example, they had a 19-play, 83-yard drive that covered over 9.5 minutes. Starting quarterback is Luke Bailey. He's a unique story. He was the backup until late last year. This team started 0-8. Bailey started the final three games. They won all three. He's back as the starting quarterback. He only completed 45% of his passes against North Dakota, but hit for 75% accuracy against Northwestern. 446 yards and three touchdowns in two games for Bailey. Now, this Drake team is mainly a passing team. They've only rushed for 207 yards in two games. A lot of weapons, though, in the receiving corps. Ian Corwin was a freshman starting quarterback when these two teams played in 2019. Corwin has switched to wide receiver, and he's caught a touchdown pass in each of the first two games. Number 80, Colin Howard, a fifth-year wide receiver, had a tremendous game against North Dakota, over 100 yards, did not play last week against Northwestern. Another wideout to keep an eye on, a familiar name to you Jackrabbit fans, number 28, Deion Campbell, the SDSU transfer, Hopkins High School graduate, 5 catches on the year for 40 yards. And the tight end is also a threat. Last week against Northwestern, number 8, Sam Rodriguez, caught 5 balls for 60 yards. Drake is very big and a veteran group up front. Their right guard is 387 pounds. 3 of the 5 well over 300, a veteran group, and they have not allowed a sack in 76 pass attempts in two games. So a team that throws the ball a lot to not give up a sack. Some of it's their scheme, some of it certainly is that offensive line. Let's turn to the defensive side of things. The best defensive player, he's a Buck Buchanan watch list individual. Number 90 defensive lineman, Finn Claypool. That's the same watch list Adam Bach is on. Claypool, in 17 career college games, has 16 tackles for loss and 9 sacks. Linebacker Jacob Thompson leads the straight team in tackles. He has 15 through two games. And talk about the safeties. They are very active. Number 6 is Tyler Radica. Number 11 is Caleb Bowling. They are two of the top three tacklers on this team statistically. And when it comes to kicking and punting, one guy does both. That's number 89, Shane Dunning. 4 of his 8 punts have gone inside the 20-yard line. He's also made a field goal on the year. Now, lots of special things with this game. Of course, tomorrow being at the home of the Minnesota Twins, Target Field. It's a 2:30 p.m. kickoff at the home of the Twins. Our radio coverage will start at 12:30 throughout the Jackrabbit Sports Network. Mason Lyseth, Scotty Quaz, and Brent Bowen join yours truly. We'll have our booth cam up and running. You can listen to us on the Jackrabbit app or the Varsity Network app. As far as your watching options, Midco Sports will have the telecast, Tom and Company. It'll also be available on ESPN Plus or on Midco Sports Plus to watch this one as South Dakota State looks to keep its winning streak alive, remain the number one team in the country, and round out non-conference play undefeated. It's the Jackrabbits and the Bulldogs of Drake. 2:30 tomorrow afternoon. Won't you join us at Target Field, the home of the Minnesota Twins?